It's a world title shot, though.
Shout out to Ness at Boxing Voice. He's on live right now with Kenny Porter and talking to him about Errol Spence. That's right. And Kenny Porter is saying he's choosing to avoid Errol Spence because he's invested so much in sanctioning fees with the WBC. He's invested. He had to pay sanctioning fee to keep Porter ranked with the WBC. And basically, he wants no parts of that IBF. Is it something where we got to blame a sanctioning body for their championship and how that sanctioning body ranks fighters? Absolutely. This is Kenny Porter. Kenny Porter. Kenny Porter, if you fight Errol Spence Jr., do you lose your investment with the WBC?
I tell my listeners over and over what happened with. Well, let me give me a chance because I do tell my listeners over and over what happened with Sean after he lost to Kelbrook. You know, he was ejected from the rankings. He wasn't even in the top 15. So I know that you guys have like a personal thing with the IBF just based off of
there. Yeah, that's been the excuse so far.
It's still a title shot.
It's a title shot. Yeah.
Mandatory slots and eliminators, not an actual shot. You still gotta wait.
Go for
it.
Hey! Quiet! Hey! Generally. Bang.
Anything sooner or quicker than the game, everybody had to wait. You asked on us for pushing arrow on somebody. They're not. The business is not pushing arrow on us. That's what you really think? You really think that?
No one said that. We want you to fight the best fighters available. Very simple. Like, that's very simple.
Ken, you don't think the fans want Earl Spence to fight a guy like your son or...
There you go.
No. I didn't say what the fans want. The fans want all this shit. I said the business. You literally believe that the business, the people behind it, are trying to push their guy out front. What if it don't work out?
So you don't... So Showtime... Ken, so Showtime or Al Heyman have not approached you about fighting Earl Spence? That's never been a conversation?
You're not going to get me dropping any names. What I said to you is, do you literally believe that they're going to take an investment? If it doesn't work out, do you understand what that means? What if he gets beat by somebody? Then that means it didn't work out and they moved too fast. They are very calculated. They are not going to make foolish mistakes. So whether you believe it or whether you know it, it's not happening for reasons that are far above your head.
So what I'm hearing is that the business is pushing Earl along slowly and
marinating, Matt. You know the word. They're marinating.
Keeping Sean and Danny and Keith away from Earl Spence, right?
Wow, he's got no answer.
I don't know.
Well, because that belt went to the UK. That belt went to the UK. We know how that works.
That belt went to the UK. Go check out the next two people he fought.
Yeah, he fought mandatory bumps.
But they were foreigners though. JoJo Dan and Kevin Bizier, because they were associated with Lou DiBella.
Who they signed with?
Yeah, I know that they signed with. I know who they signed with. I know who they signed with. That's what I said, because of their association. Look, JoJo Dan has always been with Lou DiBella, so obviously he has some association with Al Heyman. But so you're saying they're keeping you away? They kept him away from you. I just don't understand why.
He dropped from the top 45.
I just don't see
it. He didn't get a chance to rematch Kennedy. It was never even a conversation. He was dropped out of his rankings. At least we're in a conversation with Tyson Thomas. At least we're in the rankings with Tyson Thomas. There's a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel for us where he's been shown. And the other guy's ranked number two. We're all ranked together. That kind of like is the reason why. We possibly should be fighting each other. They're all WBC fighters, and they're all ranked right there together. And those were mandatory fights this offseason, which made him a mandatory to fight people.
Let me ask you something.
And there was an announcement made by the WBC president for Sean Porter, number one, to fight Danny Garcia, number two, but Danny continued to say he didn't know anything about it, so that's the reason why Sean got up in there and let him know the bullshit is over with. Let everybody know you didn't know. You didn't know. Everybody understands that I want to fight. What he decided to do with it is up there.
More pressure on Garcia, more avoiding Earl Spence.
Always have to chase down the fight. I mean, you're supposed to be with Al Heyman. Earl gets what he wants. Keith gets what he wants. Danny gets what he wants. Why are you guys like the stepchilds of the Heyman boxing? Why you gotta fly around? I'm going based off what we hear. Based off what we see.
Shout out to Ness, man. Keeping it 100 with Kenny Porter. This is great. This is great stuff. Shout out to the boxing voice, man.
He had to do the same thing to Keith. He had to bully.
He was tailor-made for him, so we just thought, okay, great. Somebody wants to fight. fight us. We want the fight. Let's go over there and make it happen. And he didn't really want that fight.
But I don't
think he doesn't want that fight now. He's talking about the star. Who said some shit like that? We came to fight and you want to come.
He said we can take it like that. We can take it to the street.
It is what it is. Shout out to the boxing voice, Kenny Porter. I apologize for my dogs, man, because they went off right when Kenny Porter was trying to make a statement. And I'm not sure if all of that's audible. But you can't fight news. Shout out to the boxing voice. Exclusive on Kenny Porter basically defending why he hasn't fought Errol Spence yet. And why he doesn't plan on fighting Errol Spence in quite some time. He's focused and invested with the WBC. That's what I got out of it. E-King Fight News. Let me know what you guys think. And it is what it is, guys. Peace out.